Bagger channel. This is Mike. It's a nice day here in November. In case you haven't noticed, it's been a while since I filmed anything. It's been a lot going on, just a lot happening with we moved. We were in Central Jersey, and now we're down in South Jersey, and just trying to kind of figure things out as far as the bite and all that stuff. In any case, back to what we're focusing on here. Bite has gotten really good here in the fall, particularly for stripers, blackfish. So what we're going to do is we're going to just try to, try to put something together today, see if we can get on a bite. And going to fish with some green crabs for blackfish, and, pretty much the use as far as lures, like jerk shads, paddle tails, things like that. Give it a shot, see what happens, and go for there. So stay tuned.
So now for this, we've got line, jigs, bait, scissors, and we good.
What's going on, everybody? How you doing? Like I said in my intro, it's been quite some time since we recorded anything. I've just been taking care of moving stuff and fishing other areas, and really haven't had anything to put on screen that I thought was kind of worth commentating on or anything like that. But alas, it's fall now in New Jersey, and it's always a great time of year, at least for me. I tend to have a few nice little spots that I can go fish in and cover off some bases on what I'm doing here. So here we are, we're tog fishing. We're using jigs, nothing really heavy, mostly, particularly I like to go anywhere from like a 3/4 ounce up to an ounce and a half. Just kind of tends to work better for me personally. So what we're doing here is I'm gonna cast the jig into the river here, and it runs anywhere from maybe like 15 to 30 feet deep depending on the area. Want to kind of get a feel for whether or not the jig's gonna hold. The current's starting to slow up a little bit. It's around the end of incoming tide going into slack. These are generally conditions that I find to be of utmost relevance as far as how I'm targeting my fish. And generally, once it hits bottom, as long as it can hold, you're basically just going to leave the rod standing up to feel out for a bite. Some of the, it might bump along the bottom a little bit as, the current drifts it upstream and everything like that. That's natural. Obviously means that you're not holding and everything, but basically what we're looking for, I swung there. Basically what you're looking for is you just want to feel like a tap, a couple taps, feel like the fish is chomping on the crab, until it quote unquote runs away, swims away with the lure. And at which point you're going to want to, set the hook and try to reel the fish in. Obviously, one of the common things that I have a problem with, when I first start doing is just trying to kind of feel out how the fish are attacking and biting the lure. So you're gonna see me swing and miss several times before I finally like settle home and I hook up into something. All right, so you're gonna watch here. Now that I'm settled on the bottom, basically waiting for the bite, and you're going to see me lowering the rod tip just to, allow them to nibble on it, chew with it, and everything like that. And this is kind of the key with the whole thing. Right here, I'm going to hook up, but a few cranks into the fight, and I'm going to lose it. It's just the way it works sometimes. Again, it's all about feeling out the bite and waiting to see how things are going to go. But as you'll see, eventually, as I work my way in through this session, I'm going to figure it out, and it's just going to turn into a lock and load session. And, kind of, how that plays in too is having a few extra baits ready to go on the bottom there. It definitely plays out in your favor, because when things are just lock and load, you'll wish you'll had them all cut at the rate that I was going. But you'll see. Hopefully, again, gives you a better picture of how things work out, and you learn a little something from this. So without further ado, I'm gonna let this one rip, let it play out, and hope you enjoy.
All
pretty nice. What do we got on the bump board?
I'm just gonna let it run. Huge, but action nonetheless. I'm cool with that. Come on, he's fighting. That's close. Whew, mama, look at that thing. That will keep. We are 15 and a half inches. Pretty cool.
So yeah, as I as you can see there, I had a keeper. Really not much size to them from this point on, though. And as you can see, the tide was starting to change, too. So I started casting more towards the middle, let it drift back downstream. That's pretty much the gist of it. A lot of action overall. I went through quite a bit of crabs as well. I think overall, on this whole trip, I pulled up about at least 24 blackfish, which was awesome. I mean, how do you beat a day like that? It was great. But, you know, that's just the name of it. You just, you know, drop a jig, keep it as light as possible. You feel the nibble, couple swings and misses. After a while, you figure it out, and overall, it turns into a really fun day. I couldn't really have asked for a better outing than this. Alright, well, that's going to wrap it up for this one. So yeah, I mean, as you can see though, it was a pretty lock and load bite. You know, as soon as you put bait on the crab, drop it, let it hit bottom, you were getting picked at and setting the hook and everything. You know, that's just how it works when you got a really good bite going on. So yeah, hopefully, you know, just kind of gives you something to like think about when you're, you know, fishing at, you know, certain tides and everything like that. You know, bring the right weight, but also, you know, just kind of time it properly so that, you know, perhaps you can hit it at a little, that's something that's a little more convenient for you, and see where it goes. But if you like this, thanks for watching, and we'll catch you on the next one.